Hello, welcome again. We are solving some conventional questions of power plant. Our topic is steam turbine cycle. Question number 88 from engineering subject main. 219 is considered an ideal steam regenerative cycle. The turbine at 3 MPa, 300 Celsius, and exhaust to the condenser at 10 kPa. The steam is extracted from the turbine and it applied to an open feed water heater. The feed water leaves the heater as saturated liquid. The appropriate pumps are used for the water leaving the condenser and feed water heater. The mass flow rate to the boiler is 1 kg per second. Determine the amount of steam extracted kilogram per second. The total pump work in kilowatt and total turbine work in kilowatt. Draw the schematic of the setup. Therefore, table is placed in the schematic setup. At one, the steam is acting on the turbine and as in some steam has been extracted to feed water heater and this is the leaving part of the steam of the turbine and after turbine it enters the condenser and then it goes to heat pump and then it is getting mixed with the extracted steam in feed water heater and heat is exchanged here and the condensate leaves at 6 and then it enters the pump again and at 7 it leaves the pump and enters the boiler and this cycle is repeated. So this is your 1 point, these are the average point according to this diagram on TL diagram. So 1 is the turbine entry point and turbine entry the pressure is 3 MPa and temperature is 300 Celsius and from for this pressure and for this for this pressure and temperature, we can see the enthalpy and entropy. So the table, so that is 3000 or 3 MPa. So at this pressure, this is enthalpy and this is entropy. Enthalpy and entropy 293.48 and entropy 6389. So we can see that the entropy at point 1, 2 and 3 is same, so S1 is equal to S2 equal to S3 and suppose S2 be the dynamic section at point 2 then and pressure at point 2 is 0.8 MPa at corresponding property we can see from steam table for the entropy so 800 MPa means 0.8 MPa means 800 kPa so this is the value of entropy. Entropy corresponding to this pressure. This is liquid entropy, this is evaporation entropy, entropy. And dynamic section is X2. So it will be 2.0461 plus X2 into 4.6166. So this is the entropy. So equating these two, entropy 1 and entropy 2, we can find out dynamic section that is 0.973. And enthalpy we can also find out by this dynamic section and this liquid and separated and vapor enthalpy so that is 721.1 and 2048.04 so this is H2 or enthalpy at point 2 and this is liquid enthalpy at this pressure is 721.1 and S7 is S6 plus pump work is specific volume into kg volume corresponding to 8 MPa or 800 kPa is 0.00 other table is 0.00115 okay so now changing pressure is here the pressure is 0.8 MPa and here the pressure is 3 MPa. So changing pressure is 3 meter over 6 minus 0.8 meter over 6. So dividing by 1000 to cut into kilojoule, we get the enthalpy at point 7 is 723.553 kilojoule per minute. Okay. So now similarly at point 3 where the pressure is 10 kPa. We can equate entropy S1 is equal to S3. So S3 is 0.6492 S3 at pressure 10 kV. This is the voltage level. And here 191. Entropy 0.6492 at 7.5010. Now considering dynamic reaction as X3, we can find out. We can equating entropy, we can find out X3 is 0.785, and enthalpy at this is your liquid enthalpy, this is vapor enthalpy, evaporation enthalpy. So total enthalpy at the considering dynamic reaction is 2070.41, and H4 is this one too, and H5 is same similar in a similar manner. H4 plus pump percent, pump work, and the specific volume corresponding to 10 kPa is 0.00100, and change in pressure is 0.8 MPa2. So 10 kPa2 0.8 MPa2. So dividing by 1000, so it comes as 192.6 kilojoule per liter. So now M mass has been extracted from point 2. So this is losing its heat from 2 to 6, and it is giving heat to M minus 1 minus M mass from 5 to 6. So this is being heated. So final condition is 6, and total mass at the final condition is 1. The total mass at the final condition is 1. That is so enthalpy at point 6 is H6, and total enthalpy at point at point 2 the enthalpy is MH2, and at point 5 the enthalpy is 1 minus MH5. By mixing these, the total enthalpy becomes H6. Okay, for mass 1 kg. So equating these two, we have H2, we have H5, we have H6. So we can find out M is 0.2095 kilogram of steam per kilogram of steam in boiler. Okay, if there is 1 kilogram of steam flowing in the boiler, then this is the mass of the steam expected. Now total pump work is here. At this point, the mass total mass is 1 kg. Because both of this mass M and this mass M has been mixed here. So this is H minus H6 minus S7 minus H6. So pump work for the first pump is S7 minus H6, and for the second pump it is the quantity pump is H5 minus H4, quantity pump is 1 minus M, and enthalpy is H5 minus H4. So it is 1 minus M, H5 minus H4. So total pump work comes to rest. Putting the value, we have already did. So total pump work is 0.31089 kilowatt per kilogram of steam in the boiler. And similarly, turbine work is also consisting of two parts, H1 minus H2 and H2 minus H3. This is for 1 kg, this is for 1 minus 10 kg. So it will be H1 minus N2 for 1 kg, and this is 1 minus N, H2 minus H3. So H1 is 29. We have all the values now. You can see as we have values. Turbine work comes there 728.27 kilowatt per kilogram.